Welcome to RonTape. At the outset of the film, we meet a 12-year-old lad named Henry Garner, who is passionate about baseball. He constantly fantasizes about becoming a professional player someday and even trains tirelessly. However, the coach at his school doesn't regard him as a skilled player. Henry is frequently benched, and whenever he does get to participate, he botches the game, resulting in his team's defeat. Henry resides with his mother, Mary, who is a loving person. Presently, she's in a relationship with Jack, a conceited man who prioritizes wealth above everything else. Although Henry despises him, he's compelled to be cordial due to his mother's sake. Subsequently, we discover that Henry is a huge admirer of the Chicago Cubs. Frequently, while doing laundry, he imagines himself as a member of the team. In school, Henry has an enormous crush on a girl called Becky, yet he's too apprehensive to confess his emotions to her. One afternoon, at the playground, Henry resolves to impress her. As a ball is thrown high into the sky, he decides to catch it. Henry nearly achieves his goal but suddenly steps on another ball lying on the ground, resulting in an awkward fall that dislocates his arm and causes him excruciating pain. Henry is instantly transported to a medical practitioner and treated for several months. Being compelled to halt playing baseball, he becomes exceedingly dejected. Upon complete healing of the bones, Henry visits the doctor to get his cast removed. Regrettably, the physician discloses that despite the bones being mended, the tendons have merged poorly, causing a faint creaking noise whenever Henry moves his arm. Despite this, the young boy appears unconcerned and content, as he can now happily continue playing baseball. In honor of his cast removal, Mary presents him and the boys with tickets to the Cubs game. It is later discovered that the Chicago Cubs are experiencing a significant losing streak, as their top pitcher, Chet Steadman, has been grappling with a shoulder injury. Larry Fisher, the team's general manager, receives news that if the Cubs fail to sell out all of their game tickets for the year, they will be forced to surrender the franchise. While playing, Chet is once again struck by the opposing team's home run. Fortunately, Henry manages to catch the ball. However, when it comes time to throw it back, he feels a bit anxious due to his recently recovered arm. Despite being hesitant initially due to his friends and the audience's persuasion, Henry ultimately throws the ball to the pitch. To everyone's surprise, the ball travels at an astonishingly high velocity. The commentators express their amazement at a ball being hurled with such power and traveling a distance of 435 feet. Larry, equally astounded, decides to recruit the young boy to his team. The following day, Chicago Cubs representatives visit Henry's residence to offer him a tryout for the team. Overjoyed that his aspiration has come to fruition, the boy promptly accepts the proposition. During a practice session, Henry throws pitches that exceed 100 miles per hour. Larry is determined to have him on the team and offers Jack a 10% cut of Henry's contract if he can successfully persuade the boy to join. Predictably, the young boy accepts the offer without hesitation. Before his first game, Henry receives a briefing on the fundamentals from the team coach, San Martinella, who assures him of his potential to become a superstar and pledges to support him in achieving that goal. The following scene shows the Chicago Cubs playing in their game. Due to the poor performance of the New York Mets' Chet, the owner and audience insist on Henry's inclusion. Despite his initial reluctance, San acquiesces. The young boy feels apprehensive as it is his first time performing in front of a large crowd. Compounding his nerves, the batter he faces hits Henry's first pitch for a home run and then taunts him as he exits the field. Nevertheless, the young boy regains his composure. Despite struggling with a few bad pitches, he contributes to his team's triumph over the Mets. Following the game, Henry goes back to his school where he converses with Becky for the first time. His friends urge him to invite her to see the boat they're building, but he feels too nervous to do so. The friends had gone to the lake to construct their boat. Henry arrives late to practice. In the subsequent game, the Cubs again ask Henry to pitch. Despite the audience's relentless chanting, his pitch doesn't show any improvement, yet he is still put on. Sion implores Chet to offer some guidance to Henry before his pitch. Reluctantly, Chet agrees and provides some unclear suggestions to the boy. Despite not comprehending most of it, Henry becomes motivated and subsequently performs admirably. Following some exceptional pitches, Henry leads his team to victory. Everyone is overjoyed, particularly Jack, who is now Henry's manager and has secured a Pepsi sponsorship deal for him. Mary expresses her gratitude to Chet for supporting her son, and the two begin conversing and form an immediate bond after the game. Over the next few games, Henry consistently delivers outstanding performances, securing victories for his team in succession. During one game, San even sends him to bat, and after the pitcher throws four balls, Henry manages to reach first base. He further unnerves the pitcher by teasing him and continuously stealing bases, ultimately winning the game for his team. As time passes, Mary and Chet's relationship grows stronger, given that the latter is a mentor-like figure to Henry. During a party, as they dance together, Jack observes them and realizes that Mary is gradually drifting away from him. At that moment, Larry Fisher arrives with some important news. The Yankees have made an offer to buy Henry for a staggering $25 million. Initially, Jack is against the transfer, but when Larry assures him of a 10% share and the removal of Chet from the team, he eventually agrees. Fast forward a few weeks, and Henry has become a massive sensation. He also spearheads his team to secure their first consecutive victories and reach the final of the division championship, where they are set to face the New York Mets once again. Due to his busy schedule, Henry is unable to devote time to his friends and assist them in constructing the boat. Moreover, he gets into a dispute with them after they make fun of him during his Pepsi commercial shoot. Jack cleverly convinces Mary to sign the sales contract by deceiving her that it is Henry's new agreement with the Cubs. Meanwhile, Larry informs Chet that he will not receive a new contract. Chet receives news that his final game will be at the end of the season. Although devastated, he chooses to accept it with dignity. At home, Jack begins to adopt a tough approach towards Henry and coerces him into participating in photo shoots. When the young boy declines, Jack taunts him by stating that his father was a coward who abandoned them for another person. Mary, upon hearing, becomes infuriated. Things escalate quickly, and she ends up punching Jack before expelling him from the house. With Jack out of the picture, Henry visits his friends and apologizes for not being able to assist them. Together, they finish building the boat and embark on a ride across the lake. During their outing, they encounter Becky and her friends and invite them for a ride as well. The group enjoys a wonderful time together. Upon returning home, Henry discusses his future with his mother, and eventually, they make a significant decision. During the day of the final game, Henry and his mother meet with the owner of the Chicago Cubs and inform him that Henry will not be returning to play the following season. He also inquires why the team wanted to sell him, but Larry avoids the question. Soon after, the game is set to begin. Despite his injured shoulder, San requests that Chet initiate the pitching. The latter is astonished, but he is also resolute in his determination to win the game. Everyone, including the owner, descends to the stands to witness the final match. Chet commences the innings with a series of decent pitches. However, his arm soon begins to trouble him once more, causing severe shoulder pain. Nevertheless, he persists in playing. During the sixth inning, he concedes several runs. In a moment of fervor and adrenaline, Chet hurls a pitch with such force that it shatters the hitter's bat. However, he is unable to pitch again as his shoulder is severely injured. Consequently, he runs with the ball in hand to make a play and get the batter out. Despite three innings remaining, Chet confides in Sam that he is unable to continue pitching and declares himself out. With no other alternatives, the coach entrusts the ball to Henry and implores him to secure a victory. Although Henry agrees, he informs the coach that this will be his last game. As he walks onto the field, the audience cheers his name fervently. Initially, he delivers a remarkable performance, enabling his team to lead by one run. As the final inning approaches, the Cubs are under immense pressure to safeguard their one-run lead. Despite this, the team is confident that Henry will clinch the victory. With a resolute expression, he strides onto the field. However, as he approaches the ball, he slips and falls awkwardly. The landing is reminiscent of how he initially broke his hand. The audience gasps, but Henry quickly assures them that he is fine. He advances towards the mound to pitch the ball, but when he ultimately does, it falls short of reaching the batter. Henry examines his arm and rotates it. He realizes that the characteristic creaking sound is absent, signifying that he no longer possesses his super arm. Nevertheless, he attempts to pitch, but his four consecutive balls result in the batter reaching first base. The audience, owner, and even the commentator express confusion and bewilderment at the scene. Henry summons his teammates for a brief meeting and confesses that his arm is no longer capable of pitching as it did previously. This news alarms his companions, but Henry assures them that he has a solution. After outlining his strategy, the game resumes. As Henry prepares to pitch, the previous batter attempts to steal a run by vacating first base. However, he discovers that Henry does not possess the ball. The outfield player executes the fake ball trick, resulting in the previous batter being eliminated. Nevertheless, the team must dismiss two more players to secure the victory. Henry repeats his four-ball tactic, causing the subsequent batter to reach first base. Regrettably, this individual is astute enough to not fall for the trickery and remains on the base. Consequently, Henry begins ridiculing and taunting him. The plan proves effective, and the batter eventually loses patience, attempting to steal a base. Henry seizes the opportunity, dashing towards the ball and tagging the runner out. This causes the crowd to erupt in excitement. The Cubs can now clinch the championship and advance to the playoffs if they dismiss the final player. The final batter turns out to be the same intimidating guy who had hit a home run off Henry before, making him nervous that he'll repeat the feat. Despite his fear, Henry throws the ball with all his might, but the pitch is so slow that it catches the scary man off guard, and he misses the ball. The batter manages to hit the next pitch, but it goes behind for a foul, leaving him with only one strike. Henry has an epiphany and decides to use the same technique to trick the batter. He throws the ball high up in the air, and as it comes back down, he loops it towards first base. Despite the risks involved, Henry decides to give his idea a shot. Miraculously, his attempt to throw the ball like his teammate gets the batter out, causing the crowd to erupt with excitement. The enthusiastic cheers continue as the Chicago Cubs emerge victorious in the division and secure a spot in the playoffs. The concluding scene reveals Henry's participation in the rookie league, where he showcases remarkable progress even without relying on his extraordinary throwing arm. To top it off, his admirer, Becky, has transformed into one of his ardent supporters.